Welcome to Yuvateck.
So the continuation of the solution for the GATE 2015 question papers problem. So here we will see that the next kind of problem, which is related with the transformer. So it is a numerical answer type question again, and it is a 2-mark question which has been asked in 2015 set 1 question paper. So they have given that 200 bar 400 volt 50 hertz 2 winding transformer which is rated at 20 kVA. So its windings are connected as an auto transformer of rating 200 bar 600 volt. A resistive load of 12 ohms is connected to the high voltage side of the auto transformer, and we have to find out the value of equivalent load resistance from low voltage side. So here they have interlinked the statements with the two winding transformer with auto transformer. So here there is, in order to obtain that equivalent value of resistance referred to low voltage side, here you have to look out that ratings 200 bar 600. Always the first one is, it indicates the primary, and the second one it indicates the secondary. So primary is 200 and the secondary is 600 for the given auto transformer rating. And here why they have given these two rating is in order to find out that transformation ratio, we have to look out the data of auto transformer, because its windings, that is two winding transformer windings, are connected in such a way that they have given that 200 bar 600. So here they have given us that is a slight diversion has been created here. So let us see the solution. So the value of equivalent load resistance referred from LV, so here which is the low voltage primary side, always 200 bar, in that 200 bar 600 or 200 bar 400, that 200 it indicates primary, and the denominator term which indicates the secondary terminal voltage. So as per the given statement, referred from LV side, so low voltage where it is available, it is in primary. So we have to find out the equivalent value of resistance referred from primary side. So that is very important here. And the formula is, so we have to move that load, we have to find out the resistance on referred from primary side. So the formula is RL by K square. So the windings are connected as an auto transformer, as I said. So the above statement is used to find the value of K. So you should not use that first one, because the windings are at what fashion it is connected is 200 by 600. So the transformation ratio should be calculated based on this data. So K is equal to 600 by 200, secondary voltage divided by primary voltage, V2 by V1. So K value is 3. And RL dash RL by K square, as we know that the load resistance is given, it is 12 ohms divided by 3 square, which is 12 divided by 9, which is equal to 1.333 ohms. So this is the required answer. So the value of equivalent load resistance referred from primary side is 1.333 ohms. So you can cross check this answer with the GATE website, and here it is a numerical answer type. So the answer is acceptable from 1.3 to 1.4. So you can, in between these two ranges, you can provide that answer. And we have to suppose in this case equivalent value of resistance of secondary referred to primary, it has been asked. So R2 dash we found, which is R2 by K square, but so which means in that equivalent circuit we will be having that two different circuit, primary circuit and secondary circuit. Refer to primary means we have to bring that parameters whatever available on secondary and we will transfer it to the primary side. So in such case we have to what divide by k square. Again I am repeat, the secondary side parameters like resistance, reactance or combinedly we will call it as impedance, load resistance, everything all will be bring into the primary side. That is what referred to primary side. In such case we have to divide it by k square. So R2 dash is equal to R2 by k square. This is what the problem it has been given. Suppose the value of equivalent resistance of primary referred to secondary side, which means the primary side, so as I said in that transformer equivalent circuit we will be having that primary side, secondary side parameters. Here the primary side parameters it has been transferred to secondary side. In such case, so R1 dash which is equal to R1 into K square. So K square we should multiply it with R1 for the equivalent resistance of primary. Suppose if the equivalent resistance of transformer, that is the entire transformer, what is that equivalent resistance? That is the combination which is given by R1E. So you should see that difference of R1 dash, R2 dash and R1E. So R1E is equal to R1 plus R2 dash. R2 dash is nothing but there we are transferring that resistance to the primary side. Next one, the value of resistance of transformer referred to secondary side, which is R2E, which is equal to R1 dash plus R2. So R1 dash can be find out from K square into R1. So the same kind of formulas can be used to find out the reactance value as well as we can find it out the impedance value. In the in the place of R we can write it as X or Z. So same these four formulas can be used to find out the equivalent values of reactances as well as impedances. And here you can cross check the answer finally. If you substitute I1 square into R1E as well as I2 square into R2E, both will repeat the same value. That is, while you are finding out or while you are calculating the copper loss, the total copper loss of the transformer, you can use these, any one of these formulas can be